Fallout 4 has been rated M for mature by the ESRB. Viewer discretion is advised. Hey guys, this is AJ22 coming today with some more Fallout 4, and we still just went and talked to this bugged out courser. I did not find a reason for why that didn't work in any of the bugs listed for the game, and I didn't want to spoil any quests by otherwise, you know, searching for what story reasons it might be that I can't kill that guy. So, yeah, we're just going to have to ignore that for now, which I hate doing. I legitimately hate doing that, but there's nothing that can be done about it. It's just the way these games work. And caution, probably from those super mutants. Oh no, I hear ghouls.
Lou, we're not alone.
Yeah, I'm aware. Yeah, there's another one. Alright, good. Looks like all the ghouls. Not even sure where exactly I'm going today. I'd like to go back to Good Neighbor. And, Where's Cambridge Police Station? That's there, right? So I think first I have a freaking a Minuteman quest too that I need to complete at some point, but that can wait. So I think I'm gonna head back to where exactly is Good Neighbor? There, right there. It's not that far off. I'm gonna head in that direction and see what this Kent Connolly guy wants. And yeah, I'll check in with you guys after I'm back there. But yeah, anyway, as I was saying, I did manage to figure out what the bug was. I thought for sure I just saw a thing I could interact with, but whatever. I did figure out what the bug was. Oh no, that's the exterior one. The interior one's this way. What the bug was with my power armors. Apparently there's an issue with the game engine that...
Hell yeah.
That clashes with a mod that I had installed, Scrap, which lets me remove additional clutter from around. I really don't like this town. I mean, it's cool in concept, freedom for everybody, but freedom can so easily become anarchy.
I need to be a lot more high or a lot more drunk to be bothered right now.
Okay, I wasn't trying to bother you. It has to do with cells resetting themselves and power armor frames in those cells can reset themselves to their original variable. It doesn't explain what happened to my power armor that I left in the Institute. I still have no idea what happened to that, which means I still don't have my X01. That kind of pissed me off. But it does explain what keeps happening to my T45 variants. So what I'm going to do is now, I've removed Scrap since I don't need it anymore. I've already cleared all the clutter out of Sanctuary. What I'm going to do is, just in case though, every time I find a power armor frame out in the world, I'm going to take it back and then I'm going to remove the parts from it, despawn it, and then spawn in a new one, because ones that are spawned in or purchased are not affected by this bug in the game engine. So that way I will still have legitimately found power armor frames. I just won't have to worry about the bug occurring if there's still some leftover bits and pieces of scrap in my game, in my save game. And I just wanted to let you guys know that. So next time we go back to Sanctuary, I'm going to spawn in some new power armor frames and rebuild my power armors. Probably spawn in the resources necessary to do that too. So I've already done it freaking twice, technically. Alright, you coming? Alright. This place is cool. Hold on a second. Piper, move. Yeah, there's the silver shroud right there. That's the character. He's kind of like their Batman-ish, sort of, in this universe. Oh, there's silver shroud stuff all over the place. Hello.
Hey there.
Good neighbor's crazy. Thefts, murders, worse. Sometimes you just got to escape a little to make it through the day.
Yeah, I kind of agree.
Escape? What do you mean?
Reliving old memories. Like Thanksgiving, 2071. Mom made a 12-pound turkey. And then we all listened to the Silver Shroud versus Captain Cosmos. Even Pa was there. You ever listen to the Silver Shroud? That's what we need. No matter how bleak things got, he saved the day.
My family and I used to listen to every new episode.
You mean when they first aired? How? The last broadcast was hundreds of years ago.
I was in cryogenic storage for a long time. I only just woke up.
Oh man, that's amazing! You're just like Mr. Abominable from episode 83.
This guy's such a nerd, I love it.
Wasn't he a caveman?
Yeah, that's the one. They found him in an iceberg off the harbor. Boy, if you just woke up. The world these days must take some getting used to.
How did you get used to everything?
Mainly I focused on survival. It got real bad after the bombs fell. For a long while, I tried not to think of the good old days. Just too painful. But it's all we got now. So we gotta try and make it better. I got a question for you.
Okay.
What if the Silver Shroud was real? With his black trench coat and gleaming silver submachine gun? I got a plan to bring him to life.
Interesting.
So he can fight bad guys and give the rest of us a symbol of something better.
What plan?
I've built my own custom machine gun. Even better than the one in the show. But to make this work, I still need the most important piece. The genuine Silver Shroud costume herself.
Oh, this is going to be an amazing quest. I'm going to love this.
They made it for the TV show. Will you help?
Yeah.
I'll get the costume for you.
You're going to do this? For real? Before the bombs fell, they were filming the Silver Shroud pilot over at Hubris Comics. So that's where you'll find it. You're the best.
We get to go to Hubris Comics and get a superhero costume so that we can turn... I don't know, are we turning this guy into a superhero? Is he making us a superhero? I don't even freaking care. This is an amazing quest and I want to get on it right this second. Piper, come on. You're my sidekick. Come on. I certainly like that your followers sandbox around the place even when they're following you in this game. It makes them seem... more alive, but it.
Better sell some to Daisy before someone.
Yeah, that's actually not a bad idea. Let's go talk to Daisy and see if we have anything we can sell to her. I do like Daisy. Like one of the few people in this town that I actually do like.
Huh?
Oh, hello, Drifter. Move.
Ooh, you're bad. Can't get enough looks at this lovely figure of mine. No? Guess you'll just have to shop then.
Yeah.
What kinds of things do you sell?
Oh, a bit of everything. Canned beans to kettles. I try to take every weird bit of junk the caravans are willing to trade. So chances are you'll find something to your liking here.
I think I probably misclicked here. Yeah, barter.
Let's see what you have.
Yeah, I like that they sandbox the followers, but it makes it hard for you to find them when you need them. Alright, what have we got here? Alright, I got some stim packs. And some 44 rounds and some shotgun shells for whatever that shotgun was called. It's something French with terrible in it.
Hey.
I can't even freaking remember. And sold off some cartridges and all of my pre-war money. Where's Piper? Like, seriously, I like that they sandbox, but you never know where they are. Let's go. Alright, so... I hear gunfire. And it looks like it's either Gunners or Brotherhood. Alright. Which way exactly am I going? I am not really going the right way. It's kind of that direction-ish. Oh, super mutants, of course. Did some damage to him with that. Don't just run in there, idiot. Gotcha. There's one up above, too, but I don't think he's actually shooting at me. Well, frickin' go through the frickin' door. I'm gonna delete this guy. Where'd he go? There he is. Oh, there you are. Hitting the frickin' Gorsak instead of the frickin' super mutant. Stop trying to kill me. It's not going to work out for you. Are there, like, stuff in these things? No, they're just hooks. I thought maybe they were, like, little doors, you know? Alright. Well, we've thoroughly ruined their day. Let's go ahead and get out of here. Is that vertebrate coming down? Or is it just circling? Yeah, let's go ahead and get out of here, Piper. Thin the herd a little bit, let whoever is dealing with them deal with them. Am I going the right way? Yeah, I'm going the right way. I just wanted to make sure I hadn't gotten turned around. I have a tendency to do that. Looks like a wreck up ahead. Yeah, there's the whole Swan's Pond area. There's apparently more to Swan's Pond than what I've uncovered, like more than just the behemoth guy. Like a whole story to him and stuff, but I have like a gunner running over there. I guess it could have been Brotherhood. They've got military-esque stuff too, don't they? Yeah, there's apparently way more to the story of that guy. Oh, that's a vertebrate. But quite frankly, I'm not that concerned about the story of it. If somebody really wants me to go discover the story of Swan's Pond, I will. Legendary Raider that's apparently been skirmishing with somebody. Alright, need to take a stim back. Alright, oh, there you are. Oh yeah, this is that super radioactive place. While I'm here, I might as well look around, I guess. Yeah, whatever. What did you have? Don't care. Instigating? That's what, like, Fury or something, probably? Piper shot somebody. Alright, well, there was somebody shooting what looked like a gamma gun up here somewhere. Whatever, it's fine. Running a little low on ammo. Should probably go and, take some right away too. And I'll drink some water instead of using up stim packs. This is a cool little park. It's got like, oh, it's got like a swan boat pond. So is that where he gets his name? Do you use like swan boat parts? I don't know. Maybe that's what people were talking about, him having more of a story. Maybe it's just that. I would imagine it's like holotapes and stuff, though. That seems to be where, how all the stories in this game are relayed. And we're like right on top of it. Here we go. Hubris Comics. Yeah, I saw this in a video. I saw it on like a in like a thumbnail. Who are you?
I can carry something if you need me to.
I'm cool right now, don't worry about it. Alright, let's quick save. And get in here. One of those frickin' monkeys. Oh, ghouls. Of course. Frickin' die! Piper, get out of the way. Pretty sure I shot Piper. It's fine, she's immortal. Frickin' go away, I'm trying to save my girlfriend. Give me that. Did you kill it yet? Economy Wonder Glue. Yeah, I'll take that, why not? Oh, hey, pre-war money. Alright, you get out of my way. You go away. Get out of the way. So I can take this pre-war money. I want it. Don't want any hand parts, though. Let's try to avoid that. Grab that. Terminal. Safe control. Yes, please. Where's the safe? Alright. And let's look at the border tracking real quick. August pre-orders. Ran out of Grognak twice. Yeah, this is just gonna be name-dropping the comics. Captain Cosmos versus the Moon Men. This is so cool. This is just like so retro comic. I'm freaking out. Alright, where's this safe that I just opened? Is it not here? Where's the safe? I just opened a freaking safe. Where is it? Seriously? Is it through this door? Dude, Piper, move!
Got it.
A lot of dead bodies in here. I don't see a safe. Alright, well, like underneath one of the ghouls or something. Didn't mean to take that. I was trying to move him. Oh, here's a thing.
Yes.
1% chance of avoiding all damage from an attack. Yes, please. Those are worth money too. Hubris Comics storeroom key. Even though I just opened the storeroom with lockpicking ability. Anything of interest here? Baseball stuff. I don't know. I'll look for the safe more in a little bit. The danger music's making me want to get going. Bathroom. Is there like a health kit in here now? Broken elevator, it looks like. And an upstairs. Okay. More guys. The music's actually kind of getting on my nerves here. Oh, they're like crawling through the woodwork. Look at that. Oh, jeez. Piper, take care of it. Thank you. Jeez. You're gonna make me have to start doing stuff pretty soon. Is that another... No, it looks like another comic book. Which would have been cool. Like, if you come in here and there's, like, multiple comic books. That would kind of break the system a little bit, I think. Apparently in danger. Head up here. Yeah, I got it. Actually, I'm pretty sure you got one of those shots. Our quest goal is apparently still above us. Oh, legendary. Didn't even get to mutate. What did you have? Irradiated hunting rifle. I will take that. That seems like a neat thing. Shotgun shells. I really should be using shotguns on these things, these guys. Ah, don't fall. Don't fall. Don't fall. Ah, I almost fell. Here are more guys. Is this an actual door?
Lock's really strong.
Yeah, it's not gonna break, okay. Okay, so I can just go in through here. Writer's terminal. This looks interesting. Use it. Come on. 10-11-77. From Vivian Odell to Tina Hopkins. Now an English butler. I'll talk with Mr. Bobowski. With Mr. Bobowski, but I wouldn't get any hopes up. Pete's brought him in because he gets television. We have to accept that there's going to be changes to get to the small screen. I agree our fans are important, but the Silver Shroud's numbers outside of Boston are, well, not ideal. A lot is riding on the success of the pilot. If Mr. Bobowski thinks an English butler could help the show, please hear him out. I love the work you and Vince have done with The Shroud. We wouldn't be shooting this show without you. I know it's tough, but hang in there. Okay, so there were actually, like, creative differences in regards to the show. Interesting. From same to same, Ree, please help. Shannon is family. I promise you I will fight for this, and this needs to be resolved before Sunday. I'm not canceling my honeymoon again over this. Make sure Bobowski doesn't sneak out before I can grab him. Okay, what is this about then? Interesting. From Aaron Bobowski to Tina Hopkins. Need lines. Tina, baby, we needed those new lines yesterday. I don't know how you do things in radio, but we got catering, Follies, best man, and actors sitting around on their tushes because the lingo here is just a little too much. It's too much. Because of your most recent delay, we're not writing Shakespeare here. It's TV, right? Well, you should still do your best, you idiot. I know you don't like the new monkey. What? But Focus loves him. He's testing better than Claire in that silly wig. Speaking of which, Claire's agent is really not loving the wig. What is going on with this? There's got to be more to this story. Really, really not loving it. Claire's flying in Monday, and by then, I think it's best if we nix the wig, am I right, or what? And Shannon's being a real peach, standing in for her while Claire wraps up her film, but it may be best if she's not around and Claire flies in. Will you take care of that? Thanks. So there were definitely creative differences in regards to how this show was going to be run. There's got to be more to the story. I hope we find out. And I don't miss it. No, it's a pencil. I don't need a pencil. There's definitely more guys. Reload. There it is, the costume.
What was that?
Probably ghouls. Did you just jump over me? Oh, frickin' die. Jeez. Whoa, you're a glowing one. Okay. Take your nuclear material from you. Did you take care of that one that I left for you? Saying that like I'm actually competent. I know she got a couple of them. That's so cool. Alright, anything else up here? There's a broken elevator. Some kind of control room. Stuff back here, too. Silver submachine gun prop. Which looks like it's just a unique piece of junk. Seriously? That's kind of silly. Anything in this? Still got that danger music playing. It's still freaking me out. Alright, is this a working terminal? Studio control terminal. Audio controls, video controls, lighting controls. I don't think we need to mess with any of that. That's probably just there to, like, mess with the ghouls if we manage to sneak past them. So, is there not more to this story then? I wanted to know more of the story. And did I miss a terminal somewhere? Is there anything else in this room? There's a... Oh, that looks like the stars room. Some stuff. Nope, don't need any of that other stuff. Anything over here? Black vest and slacks. It looks cool, but I don't really need it. Pompadour way, I don't really need it. What is that? Chinese officer's sword? Grognak costume.
Excellent.
Increases the wearer's strength and melee damage. Interesting. And it doesn't look like it would take up all your slots, either. Black rim glasses. I wonder if there's any more... like, hubris comic stuff in this building that I missed. I'm gonna have to do another... once over the place before I leave. Astoundingly awesome tales with the alien blaster. Aliens are in this game, guys. That's confirmation. It's got aliens in it. Of course it's worth reading.
That's it.
Alright, grape mentats. Perception and charisma. Nah, I'm good. Alright, let's go do another once over of the place real fast. I won't make you guys sit through that. But if I find anything else, I'll show you. Apparently there's still enemies in here somewhere. Oh, yep, found a guy. I also found another terminal. Hubert's Comics office key. Manager's terminal. You got that? Or do I need to come help? What's this? Hubert's Comics office. Oh, I guess... that's just the other way into this room here. Okay. Piper, move. You know I'm gonna get on the terminal. Yeah, more emails. Good. Vivian Odell. From Tina to Vivian. I came into work today and found another stealth revision to the shooting script. Now the Shroud has an English butler. I keep telling Bobowski that we need our core fans to be our evangelists, so we can't keep making these stupid little changes. We have to talk to him. You have to talk to him before you go on vacation, otherwise I swear I'm bringing it up to Pete. I'll freaking open the same one again. So these are the two sides of the situation. I want to pull my hair out. Babowski is cast and signed a contract with Claire Riddell for the role of the Mistress of Mystery. I don't care how much. The Tomb of Animara Gross, the Mistress of Mystery, is a brunette. Not blonde, brown, and definitely not a redhead. Okay. Grammar there is a little weird. And have you heard Claire's voice? The Mistress of Mystery is confident. A match for the Shroud is his best day. Not some half-starved waif that's known for her shrill screaming. So I'm guessing the Tomb of Animara is like, Indiana Jones-esque something or other? Because that sounds like, what was her name? Oh, the girl from Temple of Doom. I can't remember her name or the actress's name. Whatever, it's not important. Shannon Rivers has worked for us for decades. She is the voice of the Mistress of Mystery. End of story. She's even a natural brunette. She's not as young as Claire, but surely we can do something with lighting to help with that. If we don't fix this, I swear I'm walking. I won't have my name in the credits for this train wreck. Does sound kind of like a bad idea. Vivi, relax. If it's that important to you, maybe we can put Claire in a wig, but the contract is signed, so this is happening. What is it with you guys and Miss Rivers anyway? Maybe 20 years ago, but now she's got a face made for radio. This guy's a dick. Oh, trust this guy. He knows what he's talking. No, he's a dick. Radio. Am I right? Claire's got star power, and that's what we need. I talked with Petey Boy, and he's agreed to a couple of new scenes. We need romance, and Claire's got the goods. If Tina can't roll with this, then I can fly in one of my boys from Hollywood. He's a class act. Interesting. So they're basically taking the character and filling his story with cliches. Shotgun shells, which we'll take. Still, there's still enemies in here somewhere. Because the danger music's still playing. Did I get everything from you guys? Everything worthwhile, I think. Have I been in here yet? More baseball stuff. Why is there baseball stuff in here? Is that another Silver Shroud photo? I don't know why that's important, but I'll take it. It's cool. I'm sure I could stick it on a desk somewhere. What's this big glowy case here? Is there like something in here? Grognak's axe?
Hell yeah.
Whoa. Hits cause more stagger and targets take bleeding damage? That's crazy. Okay, I want to look around again for the safe that I apparently opened. Did you just jump down? You're crazy. That I apparently opened when I was here before. Don't I have a Pip-Boy light? Yeah. Never used this thing. There it is, right there. Ugh. Alright, let's see. Yeah, some decent stuff. Alright, so that's... I'm assuming that's everything in here. I don't know for sure, but I looked around the place pretty thoroughly. I guess I could check these racks and make sure all of these comics are actually burned. Yeah, it definitely looks like it. Yeah. Alright, let's, before we head out of here, check out this Silver Shroud costume. Is it miscellaneous? Oh, I've got so much stuff. Silver Shroud photo, but no costume. Is it actual armor? It is! It's actual armor! 15 and 15. That's honestly not too bad. Oh, it's 15 energy and 15 radiation. It doesn't do anything for ballistics. I do have that mod in place, though, that lets me... wear anything is under armor, and maybe I might be able to upgrade it with ballistic fiber. Actually, I think I have a mod installed that lets me upgrade anything with ballistic fiber too, to be perfectly honest. That would be cool if I could, like, be the Silver Shroud. I'm gonna have to look into doing that, because that sounds pretty freaking awesome. Alright, head back and talk to Kent. I think that's what we're supposed to be doing. Yeah, give the Silver Shroud costume to Kent. So that's back in Good Neighbor. I'm just gonna head off and do that now. Alright. He'll still be in the memory den, most likely.
Vault suit, huh? Glad
Yeah, I think I'm not changing it, though. Piper, keep up, please. Are you just always out here? Can I take this stuff? It's just bottles anyway, I don't need it. I mean, of course I can take it. It's a question of whether or not I should take it. Hey, Kent. You're gonna be super psyched, dude.
I got your costume, Kent. And some other goodies you might like.
There she is. Pretty as the posters. The Silver Shroud costume herself. And memorabilia, too? You're something else. Together with my gun, everything's all set.
What are you planning next?
I'm still working that out. Some details I want to run by you. Well, after you give me the costume, that is.
Here you go.
After all these years, the Silver Shroud is born again. But there's just one problem. I'm just not Silver Shroud material.
Uh-huh.
It could be Rhett Reinhardt or his butler, Jarvie Blake. But the Shroud is strong, capable.
Don't sell yourself short.
I got a better idea who should wear it. You up for being the Silver Shroud?
You
already got your own origin story and everything. What with the Cryo Vault and all.
Why me?
You helped me out when everyone else just laughed at me. And you're from the olden days, just like me. You know how much things have fallen. How much we gotta fight for. To make the place better. So you win?
You know what? Yeah.
Looks like I get to be the Shroud. Yay.
The costume and gun are yours. So you patrol good neighbor streets, and I'll call in any crimes on my radio station.
Okay. I was just thinking I could, like, reduce damage from humans. I didn't even notice that before. Oh, it's more powerful now. He, like, actually did stuff to it. Neat. Yeah, I was actually just going to go out and try to save the world,
but,
you know.
Here's some calling cards, I guess. When you dispatch justice, leave them behind. That way, everyone knows the Silver Shroud has returned. Time to fight crime!
Okay. Let's put this on, then. This costume, I guess. I'm over-encumbered, apparently. Piper. Piper. Piper, come here. Is that... Nah, it's just a bottle. It's a makeshift battery. I'd really like to have a makeshift battery. There's some mods that use those.
Hey.
Where to?
I want to trade some stuff.
Looking for something specific?
No, I just want to, like, give you some stuff that I don't really need. Alright, I got a silver submachine gun I'm not going to use. Because I don't... I'm just no good with automatic weapons. The hat still doesn't do anything. Let's try on the armor. I'll still have my other armor on over it. Which doesn't really work, but... I don't know, I might be able to... like, boost it up with ballistic weave and... wear it instead of the other armor, I guess. It would be a severe change in my look, but... it's something. I mean, let's look at it without the armor. Without any of the other armor. I'd lose all my pocketed, though. I'll still check it out. That. I definitely like the look of that, especially with the sunglasses. And I am over-encumbered with all the pocketed. I'm not surprised, honestly. The backpack doesn't bother me with it. Except there's no straps for the backpack. Which looks kind of silly. But yeah, overall, I like that. I mean, it looks good. It just... like, what's my armor rating right now? It's literally just, like, 84. That's it. I mean, that's just because I still have a leg piece on, apparently. Which is where, exactly? Oh, no, that's just showing me where it would go. Okay, so I don't have anything on. So what Why is it 84 then? Is that because of my... of, like, one of my perks, I guess, maybe? I don't freaking know. Whatever, so I've got the costume on. I'm incredibly over-encumbered. I'm going to go ahead and call the episode here, guys. I hope you enjoyed the episode, because I certainly enjoyed making it. Please help me out, like and subscribe, and leave a comment down below if you feel so inclined. And if you know of anyone else who might also enjoy this Let's Play, please share it with them. I'd really appreciate it. Either way, this has been AJ22, and I'll talk to you later. Seriously? In case you can't tell, I put all my armor on Piper, and I am still in the Silver Shroud armor.